Hey everyone, welcome back to another video. So the week so far has not really been too exciting. At the time of recording this video, the market is down 5%, fighting to stay above that $2 trillion mark. In this video, we're going to be going over some very frequently asked questions that we've been getting on this channel, and that is, what are our expectations for Bitcoin still? Is this another buying opportunity for the market, or has this whole previous 2-3 weeks been a fake out or a bull trap? Guys, we're going to be going over everything you need to know, in addition to some pretty interesting crypto news and articles that I found that are going to be very jam-packed with value. If you guys do appreciate this content, don't forget to drop that like down below, subscribe to the Jungi fam, and if you guys have been following along with these updates, I just want to say thank you all so much again for tuning by another video. I appreciate every single one of you for tuning by, being in here, and experiencing this journey to the moon together. So my future millionaires, let's see what's happening in the market for today. All right, so the global crypto market cap for today is sitting just at $2 trillion, or a 4.60% decrease over the last day. Bitcoin today is sitting at under $47,000 at $46,895. Before we talk about other cryptocurrencies and some of the movements that we've seen, let's talk briefly about Bitcoin and where we are at with some of the details with options expiry, some news about Grayscale Trust finally unlocking some additional coins, and let's talk about where we could see Bitcoin headed in the short term, midterm, and even long term till the end of the year. So yesterday evening, Bitcoin was back at $49,000 until we begin to see this gradual pullback in this downward channel where Bitcoin is slowly descending down to about $46,796, and it looks like this has been the layer of support in the last 24 hours. Now, I've been going through a ton of different chart theories just to see what is happening over on the technical side, and it looks like we do have two very strong scenarios. If we are able to hold at least $48,500, then we could see a bounce back up to retest $50,000 for that resistance level, and on the other ladder of that, we could end up seeing a more bearish short-term outlook where Bitcoin does touch $46,000 or even $45,000 once again. Now, I know for many of our newer investors, whenever you hear about Bitcoin going down or hearing about a minor pullback, it can get frustrating. You can freak out and you can say, why did I decide to invest again near the top? Well, I want to make sure that you do calm your nerves in this situation, because you can't expect Bitcoin to rally higher every single day. Now, we've been experiencing, luckily, for the past few weeks, a very strong movement in the price of Bitcoin, and naturally this just leads up to a stronger layer of foundation or a range of consolidation where we can cool down, pick up the volume, make sure we are not overbought before we resume those next resistance levels. You also have to keep in mind that $50,000 is a very, very strong psychological resistance level for many investors, and that is why we're going to have a hard time beating $50,000. And also, if you keep in mind, $50,000 is really the 50% level of the next resistance level that we've been talking about since the beginning of the year, which is 100K, I would imagine for us to really have a hard time here. But if we are able to break through this, which is going to take time, then I see a lot of upside, especially with all the news that we are hearing about going on right now. So before we get into that news, let's talk about one thing here in the short term that is affecting the price of Bitcoin, and this is going to be the futures open interest. So according to this article here by Cointelegraph, the total number of outstanding futures contracts on the Deribit exchange reached $1.37 billion on Monday, its highest level since May 27th, which was pretty much an indicator on the end of the last bull run that we had before the market started to correct and crash quite a bit. It says, meanwhile, the difference between the Bitcoin spot rate and its futures contract price widened, edging up its three-month basis annualized back to June levels, data provided by Stack Funds show. Now, CoinDesk also reported that roughly 25% of Bitcoin options open interest is set to expire on Friday, which is going to be tomorrow. The largest concentration of open interest is seen at the $50,000 strike price, which is also a key technical resistance level like we talked about here. Now, to make things easier to understand, I found another article talking about some of those key support levels for Bitcoin and what it will result in terms of advantages for neutral to bullish instruments. So if we get Bitcoin below $45,000, the net result is going to be $69 million advantage for the neutral to bullish instruments. If it's above $46,000, we will have the net result of $239 million favoring the neutral to bullish instruments. Above $48,000, it's going to be a $335 million advantage. And then above $50,000 for the price of Bitcoin, this is going to result in a $600 million advantage. So obviously what we want is for Bitcoin to hold these levels and to stay above at least $48,000. If it was anywhere near $50,000, that would give us a huge advantage towards the direction we want to go for a $60,000 to $65,000 Bitcoin, which is close to the previous all-time highs. Now, the reason why I am personally so bullish with Bitcoin in the long-term run, regardless of whatever happens in the short-term movement in the next 1 to 2 weeks, is because even on a fundamental level, just keeping an eye out on news, we are still seeing the overall crypto market mature very significantly. So we're going to be talking about NFTs. We're going to be going over some of the top NFTs that you need to know about later on in this video. But even with, as an example, we were getting a lot of FUD earlier this year on Grayscale Bitcoin's trust, and we realized there aren't that many people talking about this anymore. It's because even with Grayscale unlocking their additional positions with Bitcoin, we haven't been seeing that major bearish narrative that we've seen a lot of different institutions and mainstream media outlets talking about. So Wednesday, which was yesterday, the final unlocking date involved the equivalent of just 58 Bitcoin, the largest single date. And they're able to track everything using on-chain data to see how much Bitcoin would be unlocked. And there was such a strong narrative for the past few months, since we've been making these crypto updates, that when Grayscale opens up their Bitcoin, that's when everyone's gonna sell. We're gonna see another crypto winter. And I think that was just way too early to call. Instead, we got articles like this coming out, breaking: Morgan Stanley has just reported owning a large amount of Grayscale Bitcoin Trust. The largest of these appears to be 928,000 shares held by Morgan's Insight Fund. Or even Michael Saylor earlier this week, just 2 days ago, announcing that he has acquired an additional 3,900 Bitcoin, which proceeds from ATM facility sales. On a technical level, the growth that we are able to see within the past few weeks with crypto denies any type of indication for this giant bull trap many people were speculating. On top of that, on a fundamental level, we're just getting more and more support and backing from larger institutions. And don't even forget about Visa acquiring that CryptoPunk just a few days back as well. It's really hard to bet against Bitcoin when you start to take a step back and realize all that is going on in the world. Major banks and larger institutions are continuing to accumulate more and more Bitcoin and involving themselves in the crypto market. In addition to that, if you haven't heard, the Fed just continues to print a lot of money. And if you guys don't understand the correlation with the Fed's printing more money, inflating the economy, I would definitely classify this as one of the most underrated videos on YouTube, just to get a better idea on what you should be doing with your money. Now, this video was created less than a day ago by Marco from Whiteboard Finance. So let him know I sent you, and definitely watch that video after this video is over if you want to learn more about the state of the current market and its economics. Now, going back into the overall movement of other cryptos on the market, we are seeing what we normally see when Bitcoin goes down, and that is other altcoins in the market taking a slight dip as well. Now, in the last 24 hours, Ethereum is actually holding relatively strong. It's not dipping as much as Bitcoin is, still at $31.29 at the time of this recording, with Cardano at $2.54. Still up 10% in the last 7 days, but down 8% just in today. Now, not all is red. We're seeing Celo, Ravain, and Solana still up in the green today, regardless, with Bitcoin in the mud. So earlier today, I did add in some additional positions to other cryptocurrencies that I've been holding, and this is to some new evidence that I was finding in the development of the market. Now, this first relates to just how crazy the NFT market actually is. So the Ether Rock, literally this JPEG of a rock, it was purchased for over $1 million earlier this week. Now, OpenSea continues to see some record amount of new users, transactions, volume, and even the amount of total value locked into some of these other assets. In the last 30 days, we saw a 211% increase just in the amount of users and a 194% increase in the amount of transactions as well. Now, if you want to get into NFTs and you don't know where to start, in the last 6 months, here are the NFTs that have performed the best in their category. So First of all, in this article, they compare Tesla as a baseline. If you invest into Tesla stocks in the last 6 months, you would be down 5%. If you guys remember about 6 months ago too, when Pokemon cards were the hype and people were selling a lot of physical collectible cards that were PSA graded, the Michael Jordan PSA 10 Gem Mint Rookie right now is actually down 36.5%. So this may be an indication that people who have gotten into physical cards are now moving over into the digital assets as well. So NBA Top Shots is another NFT program linked together with the NBA. So instead of having like NBA trading cards, imagine getting this digital virtual cube where they call moments. So instead of buying just a card where it's a photo of someone doing like a slam dunk or Michael Jordan just shooting a shot, you can actually find yourself getting a video or like a GIF or a short clip or what they call a moment of someone doing a cool shot or a trick or breaking some ankles. So a few months back during the peak of the previous NFT market earlier this year, the NBA Top Shot market was going absolutely parabolic, but this is one of the markets that crashed extremely hard. During that time, I was in the top 1% of all NBA Top Shot holders alongside with some other YouTubers that we were collecting with. I do still have all my positions with Top Shot and I'm just going long with it, but this is definitely another opportunity that you can look into, especially if you don't want to buy into an overbought situation with other NFTs in the market. Now, this is going to be, as an example, CryptoPunk. Earlier today, I was looking for the cheapest CryptoPunk. That is going to be $250,000, $248,000 right now. And anything under that, you will not be able to find. If you happen to be a large whale where you somehow have a disposable $250,000, I would consider adding a CryptoPunk if you do not mind going long on your positions, because all of the people that own CryptoPunks are either ballers, they're early adopters, or they are going to be institutions or larger companies. Example, just like Visa or many more just to follow. Now, scrolling down, this is going to be pretty fascinating too. So VFriends NFT, this is actually with Gary V. So this launch was delayed for a while, but when it launched in the first week of May, his cartoonish drawings were a hit. Now, I was seeing this a lot within my own community of people that I went to school with. And when I saw that they got into NFTs, especially with Gary V, I realized that this could definitely be a hit. And it looks like that instinct was pretty right, because most of Gary V's NFTs are up 1,000%. As an example, it says a consistent cougar bought 3 months ago for $2,280 was sold on Monday for 26 grand, while a gift goat that cost 20 grand 3 months ago sold for $65,000. Absolutely insane. So we also have Zedrun on here, which is up 1,900%. And then we also have the Bored Ape NFT up 20,000%. I've been seeing a ton of these Bored Apes over on crypto Twitter, and usually people get these NFTs to make it their profile picture, kind of as a flex. So the example is, in 2021, in order to show off your wealth, it's not by going to the clubs and buying, you know, these $1,000 tables and popping bottles. It's actually by getting one of these NFTs and then throwing it as a profile photo. So I believe in the next few years, this is definitely going to be the evolution. It's not going to be people's faces that would be normally used for profile pics. It's going to be NFTs that people have an attachment to and that they pay money for. And then you can look up how much their NFT was and then see it as a flex. I know it's a completely weird world that we're going into. I don't know even what's going on half the time, but I definitely think that is the direction we are headed. Now, I've also been seeing this NFT project a lot as well, and this is going to be On One Force. And Logan Paul went ahead and tweeted, just dropped $623,000 on this Bumblebee. Just 2 days ago, Steve Aoki tweeted a very similar thing as well. And he said, I just bought my most expensive NFT today. One of two that got the golden mask and tiger skin, two of 7,777. This one was more than worth it. 96 Ethereum or $310,000 spent, and just look at it, absolutely powerful. Now, when it comes to NFTs, there is a cool factor behind it. Being able to see it, being able to trade it, being able to talk about it more with friends and family members. But at the same time, you have to realize the NFT bubble, I believe it's going to pop at some point too. It's going to correct. So I wouldn't FOMO into any projects if you're trying to collect short-term profits, because I just don't know where the market's going to be headed in the next few weeks. But what I would say is, if you are trying to go long and you are in the discovery period for these NFTs, even as an example, within our Discord, we have a scavenger hunt for trying to find some of these newer NFT projects. It's a little competition we're doing. And if you happen to be going long on any of these, that's when I wouldn't advise against looking into it. But with the current state of the market, the last thing you want to be holding is a piece of worthless art that is determined by the liquidity of others. So the Poly Network team has announced it has completed the recovery process of the $610 million in crypto assets stolen by hackers on August 10th. The significance behind the story was that this was the largest hacking in the crypto industry. And what was even more fascinating about this was the person who did the hack was creating like all these little hints and clues and messages to other people. So it was a fascinating story, but it looks like it has come to its conclusion. And overall, no one was hurt by this. And the fact that this happened on the blockchain network and they could track what this individual is doing with their money, and they were able to hit up one of the stablecoin companies and be like, hey, yo, you guys need to lock this down so they're not able to liquidate their positions. It looks like even in this attempt, I feel like there isn't enough credit going into the recovery and the overall conclusion of this story. And to wrap this video up, guys, I know whenever the markets go down, it can feel very scary, but right now we have the momentum, we have the institution, we still have the backing, and fundamentally nothing has changed with cryptocurrency. Even on a day like today, I dispersed about $50,000 worth of my own money into other altcoin projects that I shared within our Patreon. If we go into the total value locked for DeFi, based off of this data, we can see that we're approaching the near all-time highs of what we saw back on May. Now, I believe that we are going to surpass these previous all-time highs in terms of the TVL for DeFi, and this is just going to hint at the fact that DeFi is going to get its hype back. We're seeing this already with NFTs, and whenever you are trying to get into these projects, make sure that you have some type of positions in them so you're able to ride the wave up. Now, I'm really excited to see what's going to happen throughout this weekend. Keep in mind, if we do continue to see more additional red days, it is no need to panic in a market like this. The upside potential that we are all shooting for is still very high. We have plenty of time till the end of this year to reach those new predicted all-time highs, and there are many indicators on the on-chain analysis side, on the technical meter, even with any type of utilitarian function. We are getting a lot of good news right now, and it's only a matter of time to see where the market is headed next. Now, guys, I really hope you're able to find some type of value in this video. If you guys did, don't forget to drop a like and comment down below. Towel. Comment that down below if you guys are watching this video all the way till the end. Check out the links down below in the description. Check out Webull, where you can get 2 free stocks, one valued up to $1,850, where you can trade both stocks and crypto. It's one of the platforms that I continue to use, and I actually prefer them over Robinhood even till this day now. On top of that, don't forget to check out BlockFi, link down below in the description, where you can earn additional interest on your cryptocurrency. One last thing, if you guys need any type of VPN service, I've teamed up with Surfshark to give you guys 83% off and 3 months free if you check out my link down below. If you don't like a VPN for whatever reason, they have a 30-day money-back guarantee policy where you can get a full refund as well. Guys, thank you all so much again for watching this video all the way till the end. Don't forget to follow me over on Instagram and Twitter, link down below in the description as well. If you guys follow me over on other social media, chances are you're gonna get a scammer or someone impersonating me, and they make some pretty darn good accounts that follow you back and then DM you about some trading programs or investing stuff. I don't offer any of that, okay? The only links that I vouch for are in the description of my videos. I've received a lot of messages from my followers saying, Brian, I've been scammed by someone impersonating you, and it's been getting worse and worse. Instagram is not verifying me, and I've tried my best to report as many of these scammers as possible, but they continue to make fake accounts, buy fake followers, buy fake likes, repost all my content, and then try to scam you guys out of your money. So please don't fall for it. I'm here to provide you guys free content on YouTube. Now, other than that, guys, like always, I appreciate y'all for tuning by. Thank you all so much again. And until next time, peace out.